ओम नमो वेंकटेशाय शुक्लां वरदरं विष्णुं शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्याये सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये व्यासाय विष्णुरूपाय व्यासरूपाय विष्णवे नमो वै ब्रह्मनिधये वासिष्ठाय नमो नमः यस्य स्मरणमात्रेण जन्म संसार बंधनात्। नाउ लेट्स लुक एट दि सेकंड नामा इन दि सेकंड श्लोक। परमात्मा भूतात्मा वी सॉ इट यस्टरडे। परमात्मा परमश्च असौ आत्मा च इति परमात्मा, दट मीन्स ही इज ग्रेट एज वेल एज इज द आत्मा एंड देयरफॉर इज कॉल्ड एज परमात्मा। दट इज वन मीनिंग ऑफ परमात्मा। नाउ अदर मीनिंग इज परम उत्तम, दट मीन्स ईज द ग्रेटेस्ट। उत्तम उत्तर उत्तम ईज द ग्रेटेस्ट पर्सन एंड ईज ऑल्सो परमात्मा आत्मा एंड देयरफॉर इज कॉल्ड एज परमात्मा। दट्स अनदर मीनिंग ऑफ दट। द अदर मीनिंग इज यथा सर्वाणि भूतानि अनेन आत्मवंती न एवं अन्येन केनचित् अतः परमात्मा। दट ईज परमात्मा इज दि इनर कंट्रोलर ऑफ द आत्मा ऑफ ऑल दि जीवात्मस, बट देर इज नो पर्सन हु इज बियॉन्ड हिम। परम मीन्स अल्टिमेट, सो ही इज द अल्टिमेट पर्सन। भगवान हिमसेल्फ सेज इन गीता, मत्त परतरम नान्यते किंचित् अस्ति धनंजय, मयि सर्वम् इदं प्रोतम सूत्रे मणिगणौ विव। दट मीन्स देर इज नोबडी बियॉन्ड मी। दट मीन्स सिंस देर इज नोबडी बियॉन्ड बियॉन्ड दिस ब्रह्मन ऑर द भगवान, देयरफॉर इज कॉल्ड एज परमात्मा। सो इज द अल्टिमेट आत्मा एंड देयरफॉर इज कॉल्ड एज परमात्मा। Now let's move on to the next tiranama. Muktanam paramagatihi. That means muktanam. Muktanam is the overall the liberated people. Parama, para means ultimate, gatihi is the ultimate goal. That means he is the person who is the goal of all the people who have been liberated from this universe. So that's why he is called as muktanam paramagatihi. Muktanam parama prakrishta gatir gantavya devata punaravritti asambhavat tad gati seva. That means one who has the muktas, the definition of muktas is one they leave this from this universe, nacha punaravartate nacha punaravartate. That's what the Brahma Sutram says. That means they will never come back to this samsara chakra. They will never come back to this universe. They will permanently in the Vaikuntha, the abode of Sriman Narayana, and therefore he is the paramagati, and he is the paramagati of all these muktas. That means the liberated souls, and therefore he is called as muktanam paramagati. मुक्तानां परमागतिः उत्तम गम्य इत्यर्थः। दट मीन्स वन हूज अल्टिमेट गोल कैन बी रीच्ड ओनली बाय द उत्तम पीपल, दट मीन्स वर द लिबरेटेड पीपल एंड देयरफॉर इज कॉल्ड एज मुक्तानां परमागतिः। एवं सर्वशेषिणमेव परमप्राप्यत्वात् आह मुक्तानां परमागतिः। सेम थिंग सेम मीनिंग, दट इज वन हू इज द सुप्रीम गोल विच हू कैन बी अटेंड ओनली बाय द पीपल हू आर लिबरेटेड फ्रॉम द संसार चक्र एंड देयरफॉर इज कॉल्ड एज मुक्तानां परमागतिः। Now the interesting thing about this nama muktanam paramagati is it what you call expands the philosophy of the Visishtadvaita. Now the philosophy of Visishtadvaita is called as tattvatrayam. That means there are three principles. One is the achetana, chetana, and then Ishvara. These are the three principles. That's why you know the Visishtadvaita sannyasis, you call them tridandi. That means they hold the three sticks in their hands, dandam. The Advaita sannyasis hold only one stick, ekadandam, but the Visishtadvaita people hold three dandam, tridandi. These are the three principles. What are these three principles? The inert things. If you split the world, you can find two things. One is the achetana, that means inert things like, you know, all these panchabhutas, they are all inert. Then we have the chetanas, all these the living beings, all this, you know, this the trees, the animals, the human beings, birds, everything, they are all chetanas. So this is chetana, and beyond this chetana and parama and the achetana is the purusha, that means the Ishvara, that is the paramatma himself, and therefore these are the three principles. Now this nama muktanam, that means as per the principle of Advaita, there is only one atma, that is there is one paramatma. Whatever being seen in this world is only a reflection of the paramatma, and there is no other atma other than the paramatma as such. That's the philosophy of Advaita. Maybe at some point of time we can discuss about that. It is called the Bimba Pratibimba Vadam. Now let's focus on the Visishtadvaita principle. Now Visishtadvaita principle says that there are multiple Jivatmas. That means the Jivatma that I am is different from the Jivatma that you are. So each Jivatma is different. That's the principle of Visishtadvaitam. And then there is a Paramatma who is not same as the Jivatmas. He is different from the Jivatmas also. So that's why if you look at the Muktanam is said in plural. Muktaha means one who is liberated, the singular. Muktanam is plural. That means even after the person is being liberated, he continues to be a Jivatma, and therefore that he doesn't get merged into the Paramatma. So that is the principle of Visishtadvaitam. So Muktanam, so that means plural. and then paramagati. That means once he is liberated also, he continues to exist as Jivatma, and his role in the Vaikuntham is to render service to Bhagavan as such. So that means Paramatma, even in Vaikuntha, Paramatma is different from the Jivatmas as such. And that's what is being explained by this particular nama, Muktanam Paramagati. That means he is the person who is different from all these various muktas, and each mukta is different from another mukta, and that's why the plural of Muktanam is being used. So this is the subtle point that comes out of this particular nama. Next, we move on to the next nama. Avyayaha na asya vyayaha vinashaha vikaro vidyata iti avyayaha. That means one doesn't have any modifications or changes, vikaraha, and one doesn't have any destruction. Nasha means destruction or decline. Nothing happens to Paramatma. In fact, the Jivatma is also avyayaha. Jivatma also doesn't get, it is not perished. That's what Bhagavan says in the Gita also. न जायते म्रियते वा विपश्चिते नायं कुतश्चिन्न बभूव कश्चन अजोनित्य शाश्वतोयं पुराणः न हन्यते हन्यमाने शरीर. दट मीन्स इट इज नॉट बॉर्न, इट डजंट डाई एंड ऑल दोस थिंग्स. सो जीवात्मा ऑल्सो दैट, बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली वी डोंट रियलाइज दैट बिकॉज वी अटैच अवर सेल्स टू दिस बॉडी एंड देयरफॉर वी डोंट आइडेंटिफाई विद द जीवात्मा. दैट्स द प्रॉब्लम. दैट्स वाई वी आर फीलिंग दैट वी आर डाइंग, वी आर बीइंग बॉर्न एंड सो ऑन. सो Paramatma never dies or never is born, and therefore there is no change in him. He doesn't undergo any changes in that. In fact, our Shastra say that Bhagavan in this Vaikuntha is ever looking like a 16-year-old Yuva. That means he's like a very young person. He's ever looking like that, you know, the 16-year-old young person, and therefore he's called as, he doesn't undergo a change, and therefore he's called as Avyayaha. Na Viyate na Vyapagamyata Asmaditi Avyayaha. That means other Parasara Bhatta says one who has surrendered himself, that the Bhakta who has surrendered himself to the Bhagavan, he never allows him to get away from him. He is always under his fold, under his control, and therefore he is called as Avyayaha. Other meaning is what Satyasandha Tirtha says is Ave Suryasyayo Gamanam Asmaditi Avyayaha. That means one from whom the order for the Surya, the sun got to sancharam, that means to move about in the sky, has been given by Bhagavan as a niyama from him, and therefore he is called as Avyayaha. Let's move on to the next nama. Purushaha Puram Shariram Tasmin Chete Iti Purushaha. That means it doesn't refer to the Purusha and Stri in the sense of the masculine and feminine gender. Purusha this here means Puram. That means the body is called as the city. Puram means city. In this city, The Paramatma resides in this city. Shete means who residing in this city. Therefore, he is called as Purushaha. Other meaning is Atava Purushu Utkarsha Salishu Sidatiti. That means one who is present as a very important person in all the beings. That means he is the person who is supporting all those things, and therefore he is the important person, and therefore he is called as Purushaha. Other meaning is Puru Purna Mochakyam Palam Swatmanameva Sanoti Dadati Purushaha. That means one who is able to give, one is Purna. Purnatvat Purushaha. That means one is complete in itself. That means everything is resident in him. That's the greatness of our, Sanatana Dharma. There's nothing outside Bhagavan. Everything is inside him. Then that's why he's called as Purnaha. So Purnam, and therefore he is complete in itself, and therefore he's called as Purushaha. Other meaning is he is also able to give the final fruit of moksha to all the devotees who surrender unto him, and therefore he is called as Purushaha. Other meaning is Puru Baho Sanoti Iti Purusha. That means one is able to give lot of things to his devotees. Sanoti also Dadati. That means he is able to give lot of things to his devotees, and therefore he is called as Purushaha. Muktebhyapi Vang Manasapi Paricheda Guna Vibhavas Vanubhavam Dadati. That means for the people who are liberated from this samsara chakra, he gives them this entire ananda or the moksha ananda. That means all his qualities and other things are being enjoyed by them in Vaikuntham, and they are able to completely render the complete service to Bhagavan as such, and are always with him, and therefore he is called as Purushaha. Om Namo Venkateshaya. Let's see the other words, other namas in the tomorrow's class. Thank you.